Hello friends, welcome to this new video in which I will introduce a web application I designed to support sustainable supply chain optimization. You can access the app via the link I will put in the description and the comment section. I'll first introduce the application and show you how to use it to design a network minimizing the environmental footprint of your supply chain. Sustainable supply chain optimization is an approach to network design combining cost effectiveness with environmental responsibility. Let's assume that you are a retail company with markets worldwide. Each market has a specific monthly demand in units per month. To meet this demand, you have multiple production sites in different continents. Each site has a maximum capacity, production cost that can be variable or fixed, and a cost for the freight to deliver multiple markets. For the environmental aspect, we have the footprint of each site, focusing on CO2 emissions, waste generation, water and energy usage. What's the objective? We have to meet the demand of all our markets, with a combination of factories producing for one or multiple locations. We want to minimize the cost and reduce the environmental impact. You need data to run the model. Do you have a dataset? If yes, you can upload your own data. You start by uploading a CSV file following a template that you can download on the user interface. And you select the file name. If you don't have data, you can use a sample file. You select the button Use Sample File, and when it's selected, the data is ready. You can now move to the next step. When you arrive in the user interface, the first screen is for the data upload. As you can see here, you have the two options of using a sample file or using your own data. For this demonstration, I will use the sample file. Now that I click on the button and the option is selected, we can go on the next step. In the second window, you can visualize the parameters linked to the data uploaded. In the tab Demand and Supply, you can visualize the demand per market. On the title, you have the total demand per month. And on this donut plot, you have the split per country. On the right side, you can see the capacity per facility. For each country, you have two types of facility, low and high capacity. And for each facility, you have a maximum capacity of units per month. And for each country, you have the total viable production cost. These are usually linked with the HR cost of the company. For the environmental aspect, you go on the third tab. And for each country, you have the energy and the water consumption per unit produced, the CO2 emissions, and the waste generation. In this tab and the tab of demand and supply, you can visualize all the parameters that will affect your problem. So for the next step, we just click on the button Next Step. The objective function will set the metric you want to minimize. Let's say you want to minimize the total cost. The algorithm will provide the optimal combination focusing on the balance between production and freight costs. You can also minimize the CO2 emissions. The model here with leverage, freight distances and green facilities. You can do the same with the resources. You can minimize energy or water usage. The model will select the most efficient facilities. And now in this third and final window, you can visualize the results of your optimization. On the left side, you can select the objective function. You have the choice between production cost, water usage, energy usage or CO2 emissions. The idea here is to minimize any of these metrics, and you can select them using these radio buttons. The two first tabs are here to help you how to interpret the results. Let's go on the production cost tab. In this tab, you can visualize the production cost. On the first chart, you can see in the title the total cost of your solution, the number of sites and the number of countries. And here you have the split in this donut plot per country. So for this solution, we are producing in three countries with four factories. On the right side, you can see for each country, the split between fixed and variable cost. If you change the objective function on the left, the solution, the algorithm or the app will automatically rerun the model with the new objective function and provide you the results. As you can see, it takes a few seconds to rerun the model. And now, as you can see here, now the production cost is higher as we now want to minimize the water usage. We are still producing in three countries, but now we change one country and we have more sites. And as you can see here, the split between variable and fixed cost changed. Let's now move to the production flows. In this tab, with this Sankey chart, you can visualize the flows between the producing countries and the markets. If you change the objective function, the model will rerun and revisualize the new solution. Finally, for the most important, the environmental footprint, you have a specific tab where you can see the water usage. And for instance, let's imagine here that we move from CO2 emissions to water usage. We will see that the water usage will reduce and the CO2 emissions per country. So in this chart, you can see the CO2 emissions split between production and transportation. If you want to know more about the solution, have a look at the article linked in the description.